of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother Lambert to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ the Good Shepherd lead him safely home to be at peace with God the Father. May he be always happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Saint of God, come to his aid, come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to the God Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May the angel lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to the God Most High. Give him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever. Receive his soul and present him to God Most High. Father, into your hands we commend our brother. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with him, with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life, to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer, welcome our brother to paradise, and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ, to be with you and with our brother forever, through Christ our Lord. May the angels lead you into paradise, may the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. The man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a peace at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raised the dead to life. Give our brother eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the holy oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us sum up all our prayers and petitions and say the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, listen to our prayers for our brother, as he always desired to do your will. So in your mercy, forgive whatever wrong he may have done. By his Christian faith, he was united with all your believing people. Now in love and mercy, give him a place with your angels and saints. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Give him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever.
You can repeat that hymn, Ave Maria. Just now you all sing.
Thank you. ship at my side spreads her white sails into the morning breeze and starts for the blue ocean. She is an object of beauty and strength. I stand and watch her until at length she hangs like a speck of white cloud, just where the sea and sky come to mingle with each other. Then someone at my side says, "There, she is gone." Gone where? Gone from my side. It's all. She is just as large in musk and spar as she was when she left my side. And she is just as able to bear her load of living fate to her destined port. Her diminished size is in me, not in her. And just at that moment, when someone at my side says, "There she is gone," there are other eyes watching her coming, and other voices ready to take up the glad shout. Here she comes. And that is dying.
Holy Sonnet by John Donne. Death be not proud, the son of holy mercy and dreadful, for thou art not so. For those whom thou thinkst thou dost overthrow, thou not, for them, nor yet canst thou kill me. From rest and sleep, which but thy pictures be, much pleasure than from thee, much more must flow. And soonest are best men with thee to go, rest of their bones and souls delivered. Thou art slave to fate, chance, kings, and desperate men, and dost with poison, war, and sickness dwell. And poppy or charms can make a sleep as well and better than thy scope. Why swell'st thou then? One short sleep past, we wake eternally. And death shall be no more. Death, thou shalt die. Nayantara would sing one of God's favorite songs.
Dad was an avid gardener and had a very clean house.
I think that I shall never see a poem lovely as a tree. A tree whose hungry mouth is pressed against sweet earthy flowing breast. A tree that looks at God all day and lifts her leafy arms to pray. A tree that may in summer wear a
of robins in the world, upon whose bosom snow has lain, timidly lives with rain.